And now, a special news report direct from the Port of Tampa.
Hello, I'm Kiara, and this is my co-host, Lauren. We are reporting live from the Port of Tampa with this very special news report. What's up at the port?
You may not know much about the port now, but you will soon. We want to take the next 15 minutes or so to share with you some important news about this amazing place.
Right now, you are looking at a live aerial view of the Port of Tampa. Those cars you see are brand new PT Cruisers shipped here from Mexico. PT Cruisers are only one kind of cargo.
Let's begin our report with Don. He's at Cruise Terminal 2 with a live report.
Stay tuned.
I'm here at the Port of Tampa with just one of the many cruise ships that they have, the Jubilee. It's 900 feet in length and is approximately 3 football fields. Me and my family just last month went on a cruise here, and I mean, it was just amazing. They have like 4 swimming pools, I mean, sports on a boat. It's just fascinating, I mean, what they can do with ships. I mean, it's like a motel on water. It's a 5-star motel too. And there are so many activities to choose from. You can do whatever you want, whenever you want to do it on the ship. On the way back, I actually got to come up on the ship on the very top without anybody out here. And it was just amazing, all the sights that you can see and the open water that's actually out there. Each year, hundreds of thousands of people come to the Port of Tampa from all over the world just to take a cruise. Cruises may range from a couple of days to a 14-day adventure to South America and the Caribbean islands. Some cruise ships can hold more than 2,000 passengers depending on the size of the ship. It's a popular place. Too heavy. When we got to see the cargo of the ship, they had like humongous crates of Coca-Cola and little cans. And they had just any kind of stuff that you like. They had all kinds of different sodas. They had all this food packaged up, and they were just loading it in the bottom of the ship. Let's go over and take a look at where this lady's going.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hi. Can I see your ticket really quick?
Sure can.
Carnival. Terminal 2.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
You too.
And there is a new Channelside shopping area here at the port. Channelside's awesome just how it's got like the little escalators and the different stores that they have and the way it's built. The movies are awesome. I've been in IMAX theaters before, and this is one of the best IMAX theaters I've ever been. There was a bunch of kids here at the IMAX theater today, I mean. So obviously you know that it's good because for a teacher to pull all their kids out of class and just come watch a movie. So as you can see, this particular cruise and many others that the Port of Tampa have are fun and popular. The places around here, awesome shopping at the Channel Side, and they have a 5-star hotel, the Marriott, right across the street. And it's just fun for the kids and fun for the entire family. This is Don Hayes reporting live from Cruise Terminal 2, back to the studio.
Thanks, Don, for that very special news report. Hey, I'm going to check out the Channelside development and ask my parents to take me on a cruise ship next vacation.
That sounds like fun. Can you ask them if I can come with you?
Will do. It'll be fun. Isn't it interesting to know that it takes a lot of work to bring ships in and out of the port?
Yeah, and now we're going to go to Chanel with a report on how the port has found a way to make it a little easier to get big ships into port.
Thank you very much. Tampa is an active and growing port, which means they would have to dredge. Dredging means digging out the channel so that big ships like what Don talked about can get in and out of the port safely.
Have you ever cleaned the floor with a vacuum? Well,
Dredging is like vacuuming the carpet, but instead of vacuuming the carpet, dredging vacuums the bottom of the bay. The muck at the bottom of the bay is sucked out with a huge hose that makes the water channel deeper. Huge amount of spoil, that's what they call the stuff at the bottom of the bay, is sucked into pipes and put onto barges so that it can be taken away. They dredge so that large ships can come in and out of the port. You're probably thinking, what happens to all this spoil? Well, it is taken out into the bay and is used for a very special purpose, to make a protected private island that has become a great place for birds to nest and lay their eggs. The port takes its environmental role so seriously that it has a full-time in-house environmental department. Current projects include seagrass restoration, shoreline protection, harmful vegetation removal, and manatee awareness training. The manatee training provides information about protecting manatees at boat ramps, on the water, and at marinas. The Port of Tampa also manages most of the underwater lands in Tampa Bay, including the rivers and some of the lakes. It was hot on the boat. Then I started seeing birds and stuff. When I was walking on the beach, I found a lot of oyster shells and seaweed and stuff like that. It was fun seeing all the different things that were out there. These islands were made from all the muck and stuff at the bottom of the bay. The rocks that I was skipping, they were the same rocks that were at the bottom of the bay. And those rocks were in the way of the big ships getting in and out of the port. And that's why they had to dredge them and take them out. I'm glad the islands are here for the birds to nest and lay the eggs and stuff, and now the boats can get in and out of the port safely.
My favorite thing is the dredging because it makes a happier home for the birds to nest and raise their young. Tampa Bay has a lot of environmental responsibilities, such as the spoiled islands and the underwater lands. For any more information, please log on to www.tampaport.com. This is Chanel signing off. Isn't it interesting how the port is helping to protect our environment?
Yes, like manatees. Did you know that they were an endangered species?
Yeah, I did. But protecting the environment isn't the only thing that's important to the port. There's also cargo. With more on that story,
here's TJ.
Hi, I'm TJ, reporter for here at the Port of Tampa. Some things that you might not know about this port is that it is the largest in the state of Florida, and it is the 12th largest in the nation. This large ship here right now is transporting PT Cruisers and Dodge Rams. I hear that this ship is transporting over 490 PT Cruisers today.
The Port of Tampa has every type of cargo and shape and size. Just down the way are used cars, trucks, emergency trucks, and school buses exported to Central America.
We not only get cars here, we also send them out. We send cars all across the globe. They go to places like Mexico, and this one here happens to be going to Costa Rica.
Other types of cargo include steel, citrus pellets, scrap metal, phosphate, and orange juice. What you are looking at now are the pipes with slushy orange juice in them. That juice comes from Brazil or Costa Rica. It is mixed with Florida orange juice before it is packaged and sold. The next time your mom or dad buys a carton of juice, take a look at the label. Finally, there is the cargo that is transported in a form that you can't see. Underground pipes carry millions of gallons of jet fuel from Tampa to Orlando Airport. Cargo ships can be container ships, refrigerated cargo ships, or tankers, depending on the type of cargo they carry. The Port of Tampa is proud of offering a variety of cargo services. The cargo comes and goes to a variety of nations, including China, Mexico, Brazil, and Australia.
As you can see, this port here transfers a lot of stuff in and out. So next time you see a Dodge Ram or a PT Cruiser, you'll know where it came from.
Reporting live from cargo side of the port, TJ saying so long.
Thank you, TJ, for that very special news report. Now, we just found out, I want everyone to listen now, we just found out someone is going to be able to ride a tugboat.
And that someone is Don. We're going to go to him now, where he's going to have a very special news report on tugboats and the important role they play in the port.
Take it away, Don!
I'm here on the bridge of the tugboat, the Suwannee River, with Captain Cooper. Hello, Captain Cooper.
Hello.
I would like to ask you how this amazing vessel maneuvers.
It maneuvers with these two controls. You got a control in each hand. This little gadget right here controls the steering and the power of the boat.
And I'd like to ask you, how many horsepower does this vessel hold?
4,200 horsepower.
4,200 horsepower, folks. And, may I ask you, what kind of vessels do you tow in?
We tow ships, barges, anything that needs to be moved, we'll move it.
Okay, and how do you like your job?
I love it. I've been doing it all my life.
There you have it, folks. That's what's on the tugboat. Tugboats do great things here at the Port of Tampa. I think they're awesome. Tugboats may not look sleek and powerful, but they are one of the most maneuverable ships on the water. And they are very powerful. Some tugs have 10,000 horsepower. That's about 37 times more powerful than a pickup truck engine. They help ships move around in confined areas. They also help ships that break down at sea by towing them into port for ship repairs. Don Heiser reporting live back to the studio.
Thanks, Don, for that very special news report. Hey, you know what? There really are a lot of jobs here at the port. Now, let's check out the economic impact here at the port.
Watch this.
Hi, my name is Alyssa, and here at the Port Authority, one of the most important things they do is repairing and fixing the ships that have something wrong with them. Ships don't float unless they're in good shape, and the port facility and companies that repair ships are important to everybody down here. Lots of people work on building and repairing ships, and a lot of these jobs require a high degree in technical skill. One interesting part of the ship repair business is watching a ship make its way into dry dock. This is necessary when a ship needs repair. This process calls for sinking the repair facility, called the dry dock, by filling its hollow sides with water, sailing the vessel in, and then draining the water from the dry dock, raising the ship so it sits on dry land for repair. Down here, there are pipe fitters, ship fitters, steel workers, welders, mechanics, painters, and electricians, and a whole lot more, just to name a few. Shipbuilding and repair is an important business at the port. Other great jobs at the port include stevedores and longshoremen. Those are workers in charge of getting cargo on and off the ships. There are jobs on cruise ships, helping customers in channel-side shopping area, working with computers and offices, and many more types of jobs at the port.
This project's taking place down over in this area, and I believe over in this area here.
A lot of people work in this business, and it takes hard work to become good at what they do here. It's really quite amazing. This is Alyssa coming to you from the Port of Tampa.
Thank you, Alyssa, for that very special news report on ship repair. Don't forget you can have a free boat ride down in the port.
One of the best ways to see the Port of Tampa is by going on the Port of Tampa tour. This free tour will give you the best views of the port, and you can experience it the way the sea captains do, from the water. Check out the cargo ships, stevedores, ship repair facilities, cruise ships, and many other cool views from the water. It takes about an hour and a half to do it, but you'll be glad you did.
I'd rather go on the boat tour of the Port of Tampa than stay at school. Isn't that right, Lauren?
I have to definitely agree with you there. And even if you do go on the boat tour, you're still learning something.
Right.
For any more information, log on www.tampaport.com.
Thank you, all you reporters, for your very special news reports today.
Do any of you reporters have anything to say before we sign off?
If you do, say it now.
Or forever hold your peace.
Thanks. You know, here there's a lot of boats that need to be repaired. So one of the most important things they do is fix them. Many people work here at the Port of Tampa, and their jobs take special training. They're very important to us here.
So as you can see, cruises are fun and popular. I mean, they even have the channel side shopping area across the way from your cruise. So kids, bring out your parents and have fun on vacation.
My favorite part is dredging because they use the waste to make an island for the birds to nest and make a happier home.
All right, right now, if I leave you with anything, I just want you to know that the Port of Tampa is all about cargo. From juice to cars and from Mexico to Tampa, we have it all. Cargo, cargo, cargo.
Cruises are fun and popular.
Dredging.
Cruises are fun and popular.
Dredging, dredging.
Cruises,
dredging.
Cruises are dredging.
Cargo.
People work here, people work here.
Cruises,
people work here.
We have it all.
Dredging.
Cruises are fun and popular.
But we have it all.
Right. Lauren, I learned a lot about the port today. Have you?
Oh, yes. I learned about dredging and the environment and how the port helps to preserve it.
Right. I learned about the port and the environment also.
And what about those little tugboats?
Right. I learned about brand new PT cruisers, how they be shipped in and out of the port. I know that is a lot of work.
Yeah. My favorite part was the cruise ships. They look so cool.
So is mine. I think we should say bye to the audience right now.
Okay, but before we go, remember to study hard. And if you have the chance, come down and visit the port. It's a really cool place.
Study. Until next time.
Bye.